Sound. Okay, c'est bon.
All right, the sound is back.
Sorry.
Okay, we can start. We can start all over again. So basically, what I was saying, and maybe some of you can lip read, and you know maybe understood already what we were saying, but I doubt it. Welcome to part four of this illustration stream that we're doing here live on AdobeLive.com, and our next guest is Maite Franqui.
Hi. Hi,
hello,
everyone.
Maite. Welcome to the stream.
Thank you.
Yes, and you should all know that it is now 10 p.m. here in Paris because we're streaming live from Paris. So thank you for being here at 10 p.m. to talk
you
about
too.
your designs and your illustrations. And I thought that before we begin, let's give our audience a little understanding of who you are, maybe what your background is,
mm-hmm.
and. Yeah,
so I'm a freelance illustrator since a year and a half.
Mm-hmm.
Before that, I work as an art director in
art
an agency,
okay.
in a different agency. And then I quit my job, leave Paris,
mm-hmm.
and I moved in Lyon and became an illustrator.
Okay, so is moving to Lyon like moving to the province, or is it another big city?
It's a big city.
It's a big city.
But I feel like if I am on holiday every day.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
It's more sunny than Paris?
Yeah, really.
Okay. So what made you decide to leave art direction and jump into illustration?
It was like my dream when mm-hmm. I was studying graphic design. And I just try to do it. I was thinking that if... No, I succeed, mm-hmm. so I stay as an illustrator.
Okay, so what is it that sparked this change in you? What is it? Do you remember the day when you decided,
I'm
going to do it?
I was bored in agency.
Yes, okay.
Yeah. I'd like to do something by myself.
Mm-hmm.
And
I think boredom is a good trigger for change,
yes.
right?
Yes.
Okay, so I have your Behance page open here, and maybe you know we can just look at some of the work, and you just a little bit of explanation, and
yes,
maybe do you want to choose which ones?
Yeah, maybe the last one.
This one, laughter.
Yeah, the subject was pretty difficult. It was about brain injuries,
mm-hmm.
and I decided to turn in. It's a the use of laughter therapy in brain injury rehabilitation,
okay.
so it's quite difficult. But I decided to put lot of colors and smile to be like,
Wow, I love it. Laughter is 3,000 milligrams.
So I work mostly with the illustrator, mm-hmm. I think maybe 80%.
Mm-hmm.
And then I use Photoshop to add texture,
mm-hmm.
Brushes and light.
Okay. There's a little bit more details here. Awesome.
Yeah.
So guys, if you want to know more about Maite's portfolio, you can go on the AdobeLive.com page. There is a whole section about the speakers, and there will be links to more information about Maite. So now, of course, we're very eager to know what are we going to be doing in the next 3 days. I was going to say 4 days, but that would have been scary.
No,
in the next 3 days.
So I'm going to create one illustration per day,
mm-hmm.
in 2 hours, if I can. So for the first day, I decided to draw a tribute to a city I visit in August, mm-hmm. Lisboa.
Okay.
We
love Lisboa.
Like everyone fell in love with the tramway. So I decided to show you how to create one. So first of all, I drew a sketch last week, and I always use a sketch
to start with.
Yeah, to start with.
And how do you sketch? Do you have a sketchbook always with you?
No, not at all.
Just a piece of paper you
it's
find?
Like any pen I see, I found.
Okay.
A piece of paper, an envelope or something.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care.
Okay.
Really. Sorry. I'm not very... for me, it's difficult to draw with a pen, so it's like very sketchy.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, it's enough.
How do you transfer your sketch into Illustrator? I see more and more people just taking a photo with their phone and...
a scanner.
You use a scanner. Okay.
I can take a picture, but it's quicker to use a scanner.
Huh? maybe.
Yeah.
Everybody has their systems and habits, I
guess.
Of course. Great.
So, I've just imported my sketch of the tramway. And I've already chose my colors.
Oh, that's interesting. How do you choose your colors?
I change for each project.
Okay. So
I'm obsessed with blue, but I try to change.
Okay. Yes, everybody has their like personal palette.
Yeah.
But like for Lisboa, what inspired? How? Yes.
I like the contrast between the yellow and the blue.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, we'll see.
Okay.
If you like it.
Okay. All right.
So I just import my sketch, and I'm going to create a new layer, and add my sketch in the layer.
Hussein Nagaria says, okay, let's do it.
Namaste
Sannai.
Oh, great. And then I put the layer just right down. And I double click here to change the mode of the layer. I click here in template. So I could see my sketch anytime I want.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to create the windows. You know, perfect sketch. So here we go. I don't care about color actually for now, because I just going to use this mode, outlines. So I can see the lines and my sketch. If I change the mode, my sketch is hide, so it's not easy. So
I just changed the screen because we were still on my screen.
I can start.
No. We understood that you imported the sketch.
Mm-hmm.
You transformed it into a template layer, but maybe just show your color palette again.
Yeah.
In
okay.
Between the two artboards.
Just right here.
Okay.
I always
this
use.
This is what we were talking about.
Yes. So here we go. I'm going to create the window. Mm-hmm. Here we go. And ID.
Also, because this is a question I know people will ask, what is she using? You're using a bamboo.
Bamboo.
Welcome bamboo.
Yes. Okay. Very classic.
Are you using? So it's a classic bamboo pen.
Yes, it's like maybe eight years ago.
8 years old.
Okay. Yeah.
Hey, but if it works.
Yeah, of course. I like this one. So maybe just right here. I use very basic shape. I don't like draw. You know, with the pen.
With the pen tool?
No, I use basic shapes. Okay, just like that. And now
yes, and this is very important as well, that we will be giving away twice in every session. Actually, we're going to be giving away two posters today with the final artwork that we will be producing. We will be printing them out.
Okay.
You will be signing it.
Okay.
And we will send it out to the lucky winners.
Okay.
Winners. Yes. Michael has a problem with winners.
Okay, so here we go. And now the window. And as you can see, there is a lot of window. So I'm not going to duplicate it from this one. But I'm going to create a symbols.
Ah.
just right here, window. And then I can duplicate it, even change it a little bit. And then...
So you just placed symbols there?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
It's the three are symbols. So, no.
That's a very interesting workflow because creating symbols, like instead of, had she just copy-pasted the three windows, it would have been, you know, redundant data. I mean, you know, all these points would have been described more times, and by using symbols, you actually simplify your Illustrator document, which is a really great workflow. Yes, Diseño Los Cabos is being very facetious.
Okay, and then. So, as you can see, I only draw the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm going to create a new symbol with this part and then create like
a reflection?
A reflection.
Well, Zrebe Dimitri, the sketch was scanned. So Maite sketched on a piece of paper and then scanned it in and brought it into Illustrator and changed it into a template layer. This is so great, you guys. You're answering the questions in the chat. So cool. Now that you've seen the type of illustrations that Maite does, if there's any illustrations that you guys want to share with us so that Maite can have a look and maybe give some constructive feedback on them,
yeah.
please do share them on Twitter using the Adobe Live hashtag. Hashtag Adobe Live. And we'll look at those.
Here we go. No, I group here and create a new symbol. Okay.
Do you name your symbols?
I should.
this is always the, you know, the thing. Do you name your layers? Do you name your symbols?
Yeah, I know. I forget this part.
We should make a t-shirt like, life is too short to name our symbols.
Oh, I can do it if you want.
No. It's your workflow.
Okay.
If you don't name your symbols, you know, that's fine. It's just me being Swiss, you know, it's like, it makes me hurt inside. I'm like, she's not naming the symbols.
So, the reflection. Here it is.
Another great benefit of symbols is if you ever want to change one of the sides,
yeah,
it automatically updates the other.
Because actually I'm going to create like a basic shape, mm-hmm, of the tramway. And if I get time, I can add details in the symbols.
Mm-hmm.
And I heard time.
Yeah.
Finally. It's the same here.
Yes, Hossein, that's exactly why we have these streams, is so you guys can see actually, you know, how other artists work and how they create their artwork. And I think there's so much to learn. And we're ever so thankful that, you know, these artists share their knowledge with us.
But if you have tips for me, it's great too.
Yes.
Okay. There is a problem here. So now I can have these parts.
There's some nice illustrations coming in through Twitter that we can look at later. Whenever you feel that you want to look at some other people's work.
Yes, yeah. Of course. Already?
Let's go ahead.
Okay.
Oh, there's, yeah, people are submitting things. That's really great.
Oh.
Sanai, I will not say Adobe Suite because there is no suite. There is only Creative Cloud. It's called the Adobe Creative Cloud. It used to be a suite. Sounds like sweet.
Okay, so I can add this part to the symbols.
Okay, so basically what we're doing here is creating an illustration for an illustration about Lisboa, and it all starts with a sketch, and basically just by using simple shapes and creating the shapes that you need for this tramway. Is it a tramway?
Yeah.
Say tramway?
It is.
Can we say that in English? Tramway?
Tram?
Okay. And a cable car. That's in San Francisco. Maybe it's just
maybe
a cable car.
Same,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think
yes.
Huh. And then I used duplicate. And
oh, that was so precise. How did you? That was luck. To have the.
I can show you how it works, but maybe it's luck. No. So you created a point of
yes.
a shape.
Mm-hmm.
You click on Alt.
Yes.
And Shift.
Yes.
And then.
And then duplicate it. Yes.
And then it's Control
mm-hmm.
and D.
Yes.
And it's duplicate the last action.
Yes. Yes. But you managed to get right to the point where the last one should be.
Ah.
This is luck. This is luck.
Yeah.
Otherwise, if it was like a little bit tweaked off, you could have maybe auto-lined them, you know. But yeah.
No, it's luck.
And that's the cool thing here, guys, is all these simple shapes that are being used. And no pen tool here. Maite doesn't like the pen tool.
I use it sometimes, but it's really quicker with mm-hmm. a simple shape, mm-hmm. like a round or a rectangle. So. Is that maybe too dark? And I always use the smart color.
Mm-hmm.
If I want to change one. Just by clicking here, for example,
uh-huh.
all the purple. No, I just
The global colors.
The global
yes,
colors.
Yes, yes.
So for me, it's like magic.
Yes, that's a very important tip. When you create swatches in Illustrator, you can always choose if you want them to be global colors or not global colors.
Yeah.
And basically, what that means is. If you don't choose global and you apply the color on several objects and then you change the color, nothing will happen except for future objects you make. If you have selected global colors, on the other hand, it makes it so much easier to then change the colors in the whole illustration.
Mm.
Dimitri said it's not luck, it's It's called being a pro.
Thank you. I should lie. If only.
Yeah, in the color guide window, that's an interesting point, Adam, is that, yes, this gives you tints and shades of specific colors you've been using. Do you use these color guides and the coloring tools in Illustrator?
Not
this is
so
interesting
much.
Because we've had Maria before.
Yeah, I saw this part.
And
it was very, very interesting.
She was applying colors in completely different ways. And this is the thing I always say, is that there is no right or wrong way to do things in Illustrator, in this case. It's whatever makes more sense to you and whatever you know you feel more comfortable with.
Yeah, of course. But I'm going to try some tips of Maria.
Okay.
He was very interesting.
And yes, all of these, of course, now we're live here on AdobeLive.com. All of these videos will, of course, be saved to our Creative Cloud YouTube channel, and you can watch them later. If there's a part you missed or a thing you want to see again, you can always go back there and check it out.
And now, as I want to create the other windows, I just go in my symbol of the first window and use it to create the second one.
Oh, and so you're working in outline. You're working in outline mode, so you can see
yes.
the background. Okay,
yeah.
I get it.
And now, just add it maybe. And then I can give the illusion that it's a new window.
Mm-hmm. I like that. Give the illusion.
It's why I like Illustrator. It's very quick.
Yeah, Paul Weaver, that's right. The only wrong way to do art is not to do art at all. That's right. That's very profound.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. I change the opacity. And the new window.
So, girl, you know it's Drew. Yes, we're testing out, you know, how the YouTube platform works for this now, and you know, we'll see in future how things go. This
just
is another thing that Maite does a lot. She goes into isolation mode, and basically what that means is she enters the illustration like going into, it's almost like going into a layer, but it's not really a layer. It's like just opening a specific object, in this case symbols,
yes.
right? And
yeah.
then transforming them.
What?
Oh, you create a new symbol here.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you know what the little plus sign means?
I think it's to add the symbol to the how do you say library?
Oh, okay.
Cloud library, so I can get it from Illustrator
okay.
too.
Okay.
I think I don't know, but because I saw it for the first time the last week.
Okay.
So maybe.
Yeah, I haven't seen that before.
I don't know.
Could be wrong.
And some details.
Yes, we'll look at the Twitter tags in just a second. The Adobe Live hashtag.
Okay. Maybe up.
Were these details in your sketch, or is this something that you add as you go along?
I don't know. In my sketch.
The little dots, I mean.
No, it's just me. If I have time, I always had some things like...
That's another interesting concept that, you know, that we saw with Maria, is that a sketch is only, you know, the beginning of an idea, and then it can change.
Yes, of
course.
As you
go along. It doesn't need to be... Your illustration never needs to be exactly like your sketch was.
No, because it never works like that.
Jason Perry, here you go. The plus sign means dynamic symbol, and it can be recolored.
As a symbol?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Okay, so... And the window, I group it. Whoop.
Don't worry, Paul Weaver. We'll do whatever makes sense. It's already taking shape. It's incredible. Do you want to take a quick break and look at some artwork?
Yeah, with pleasure, of course.
Let's do that. Let's just go to my screen for a second. This one, yes. And go. All right, so basically this is the first one that was sent in from Coffee Caffeine.
Great.
And
only with Illustrator.
Coffee Caffeine, if you're there in the chat, is this done only with Illustrator?
Yeah, I like the lights. That's great.
Let's look at
Coffee Caffeine.
This one. Oh, what was that? It was Illustration, Illustrator, After Effects. Mm-hmm. Okay, there also, maybe using simple shapes to create shapes.
Yeah.
Ah, this is a complex illustration.
Oh, quite impressive. I like
the coffee. It's Coffee Caffeine again.
Oh.
So let's see if Coffee Caffeine...
You never stop?
Never stops. That's a great, great, great way, great style.
Yeah. Oh, how many hours? Could you tell us?
Coffee Caffeine. It's your time in the spotlight. So we'll see in the
Don't
chat
be late
in a few seconds.
After midnight.
Oh, there's another one from Coffee Caffeine.
Yeah. With the pencil.
Maybe with the even brushes could be. Oh, another one, Octo.
Coffee Caffeine.
Yeah,
is your
caffeine
portfolio here?
Never stops.
Yeah.
So I guess there's various kinds of media there as well. You know, some maybe this could have been made in Adobe Illustrator Draw, maybe on a tablet.
Yes.
Or maybe drawn directly in Illustrator with the brush tools.
It's possible.
Mm-hmm.
That's great.
The big Lebowski character.
Yeah, I love this movie.
M.A. Yeah, that's
great. I love it. I love his nose. Great.
Oops. Let's see. This is part of a challenge that I did to make an illustration every day in no more than 2 hours. Unicorns versus pizza. That's a nice challenge. Very good.
Yeah.
I love the textures in here as well. The background here.
Yeah, so many gradients. Great.
Oh, Shivam is Coffee Caffeine. It's pure Illustrator.
Oh. Good work, Shivam.
Very good.
Yeah.
And then somebody's working here on another illustration that looks... Looks almost like something that James Curran like could animate into an animated GIF.
With the bear right here.
Yeah, yeah. Nice.
Yeah, that's great.
Cool stuff. Thank you, guys. Keep it coming. We'll be looking at it.
With pleasure. So, let's get finished this one. Maybe it's dark. It's too. Yeah, that's better. So now I'm going to draw the door with basic shape too.
Yes, very awesome work, Coffee Caffeine.
Coffee Caffeine, I like it.
We know how much it takes to be so precise, and takes a lot of time and patience and hard work.
But keep on working, that's great. But are you a professional illustrator? Coffee Caffeine? Can stop telling his name, Coffee Caffeine.
Coffee Caffeine, yeah. That's what we need right now.
Yeah.
Coffee and some caffeine.
And I had a window.
Diseño Los Cabos says, I feel bad because she's working and I'm lazy watching. Frankie, it's simply moving from one view to the other. So basically, there's an outline view, outline mode, so that you can see what's in the background and with black lines in the Illustrator file. And then back into preview mode, which is this one, where you actually see what you're designing.
Yeah. When I need to see my sketch, I just change the mode, outline, and then preview.
How do you divide the objects with a shortcut? Did you divide something? How did you divide?
What is divide?
Objects, diviser. Did you cut something?
Maybe that, just tell me. I had a new shape.
Yeah.
It's maybe something
okay.
Like that.
So using the Alt key, basically you're cloning, you're duplicating the object.
Yes.
On itself. So.
On its left. Wait, yeah.
Okay, so
like that,
it's not really a division, it's just a duplication of the object while you're modifying it. And that's by pressing down the Alt or Option key. Alt on Mac and Option on PC, right?
Yeah. And then?
And Command Y for outline mode. Yep.
Just for you.
You named one symbol just for me. What did you name it?
Door.
Door, okay. Mitten Camper says, can you show the layers you produced now on screen? No, because you haven't used any layers. Do you use layers?
Never.
It's
no,
always
not
one
never.
Layer.
Just okay. Maybe if I have a complicated background. Yes, of course. No. But actually, I don't need layers because if you group all the symbols and you don't have to use,
yes.
For me, I don't use, I don't need to use layers.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? If you have discipline in your illustration, like using symbols
and naming
it, it makes it easier. And like we said before, you know, whatever is more comfortable for you is the correct way to go.
Yeah.
Ian Lim, yes, there will be replays of this video as soon as we're done with the live session here. It'll be available on the Creative Cloud YouTube page.
And then, what's the name of the far?
Oh, it's a spot. It's not the headlight.
Headlight.
Yes.
Of the tramway.
The headlight of the tram. There's a question by Ivan. Do you ever make your sketches more refined before you go into Illustrator? Or are they...
Yes, for clients.
because they want to see sketches.
Yes. Because it's difficult to show a sketch like that to the client because they can imagine the final version.
That's so a very good tip. Yes.
You have to be sure that the clients know what is going to be at the end. Yes, I make effort to draw better sometimes. No, it's very important. Maybe we could have something for the light with a gradient. And then I change the opacity to 0. And the blending mode in opacity. Because it fits better with the color just under.
Ah, what shortcut was that to send behind the object you just finished?
Yeah, and maybe something like that. I may be going to change this.
So we're seeing that Maite is using a lot of shortcuts.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh.
So what was the shortcut to send it? To send it, because you just sent it back into the back of the elements you've just created, right? This, like, you did the headlight, and then you just sent it the shadow back.
Yes.
Yes.
It's different, I think, for PC or Mac.
Yeah, I don't know. Is it like minus or plus or what?
It's the I don't know.
Oh, the square bracket.
Yes.
Okay.
But you can change it.
Yeah.
By going to the edit menu.
Well, not being a shortcut person, I usually go to the layers panel and move the objects around in the layer.
I know.
Yes. That's how I do it.
Yeah, I just change it here. It's send backwards. I'm going to change it because it's not the usual one. Yeah, better. And okay. Oh.
Devil bot. It's not devil, it's night bot. Yeah, night bot is being very, very pesky today. Yeah, that's right. The color selection is so nice. And this is also something that, you know, that Maite started with before starting the illustration, the deciding on the color palette that she was going to use. And it's actually really cool because you're like choosing the colors ahead of time. You're actually limiting your choices while you're drawing, which makes it super easy.
You waste time by don't know what you are going to do.
James Lewis Van Voorst, you rock. I mean, control plus square bracket or square bracket. Diseño Los Cabos asks, do you use a live paint tool sometimes, like we've seen Maria do today?
No, but I think I'm going to try because it was very, very interesting. But it looks like so easy with Maria.
What are you guys going on about tagging Adobe Creative Cloud? I don't know. The only wise thing to do is to, let me see if I get the finger right this time. It's down here somewhere. There's a subscribe button. Okay, so if you want to be alerted of future streams and things we do here, that's the best way to know about them.
And then the wheel.
Ivan is asking an interesting question. Do you ever reference imagery when you create your illustrations? Like when you were in Lisboa, did you take pictures of the tramway?
I take a picture and then I try to simplify the shape. I do a lot of screen printing.
Mm-hmm.
It helps me to think like simply.
Mm-hmm.
And I like to add details, but you know, it's simple, but you can see that it's a tramway.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
but I try to take pictures when I want, when I need to add details, like maybe for big posters, mm-hmm. or maybe for animation, or you know, like advertising. If the format is really big, mm-hmm. it's more interesting if you can see a lot of details everywhere.
I know a lot of illustrators who also use Google a lot, like to find, you know, images that, like if they do a scene or something, they find like hundreds of images like they can reference to.
I try to not go to Google so much, mm-hmm. just to use my imagination.
Yes.
And then when I receive the brief, the first step is to turn off my computer.
Ah, okay.
Just to have my own idea, yeah, and to make, I write a lot, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. make some sketch, mm-hmm. and after that, I turn on my computer and maybe if I.
Do you think that's your art director background?
Maybe.
Taught you that?
Maybe. I never thought that. Yeah, maybe.
Interesting, very interesting. But I love the idea of turning off the computer in the ideation phase. I think that's super.
But your hand, it's a pretty good tool.
My graphic design students used to hate me because I would not let them go to the computer until maybe week 6 or 7.
Ow.
Everything was by hand before that.
But it's good because if you want to explain an idea to your client, you have to like think quickly, draw quickly, even if it's not the best draw you have ever made. For me, it's very, very important. Mm. And then I'm going to create azulejo. I love it.
In what does Lisboa. That mean?
You know, it's the pattern on the wall. Mm-hmm. You made.
Oh yes, it's ceramics, right?
Ceramic.
Yes. It's like tiles.
Tiles,
yes. Okay. Ceramic tiles. Okay, I think we like in about 10 minutes we're gonna be raffling out an autographed poster of whatever the result will be here in Maite's illustrations. Is it gonna be all three together, or are we gonna have different posters, Michael? What do you think? Rose window, yeah. Azulejo. Azulejo. Yeah. It also has the word azul, which means blue.
Yes,
they're blue, right?
I think it's the right name, yeah. Azulejo.
Yes, Luis. She uses a 8-year-old Wacom bamboo tablet.
It's my favorite one.
Stalactite, no, you're not wrong. Maite is from Lyon. From the southern part of France. Can we say that? Is that already south of France? Lyon?
Yes. It's a great city. With the mountains.
Mm-hmm. Ah, the mountains.
Ah, yeah, great.
This is the one thing I miss. I live in Florence in Italy.
Oh, yes. My family live here.
Yeah?
Yes.
Ah. Frankie. and I moved from Switzerland to Italy in 92.
Oh.
Yes. And every time I go back to the mountains, I go, wow, yeah. I miss the mountains.
But it's such a beautiful place.
Yes. Yes, Gabriela, we will. We will be looking at Twitter again. Anything that is tagged with the Adobe Live hashtag Adobe Live, we will be looking at. And Maite will be giving some constructive feedback. Or simply say that you like it.
Yeah.
Or not. I can't imagine you saying you don't like it.
No, because it's always great. If you want to do something, that's cool.
That's an interesting question from Brad. He came in late he came in late, so he's sorry, but it doesn't matter. You can come in anytime. But he's very interested in work time to payment ratio. A lot of time when creating this sort of illustration, and it never matches the per hour rate. Do you have any mathematics you do, or?
Okay, could you?
Okay,
you do
so
the translation for
basically,
me?
I don't understand. Like, as a designer, when you charge per hour, of course, you know, it can, if you spend too much time on an illustration, maybe it can blow up. On it's do you charge by the hour or by illustration or?
No.
I don't want to go into any specifics, but
yeah, of course, but I mostly it's by project. But I have wonderful agents.
Agents
at Folio Hat.
Okay. Hello, Maite's agents.
Yeah.
They're watching right now, you know that.
Maybe.
Yes. Well, maybe not. It's almost 11 p.m.
Drop a message, Alex, if you are here. So, they are lovely because, no, I don't have to negotiate or, you know.
Ah, that's awesome, yeah. But Brad, yeah, the billing the billing is always a very, very tough subject in any creative work, really. And I don't think there is any golden rule. The only thing is that, you know, I don't think artists should ever starve. That's for sure.
But it's up to you. If you feel that you can do it, so just let go. But if you don't feel comfortable with the price or the project, just feel free to say no politely, but say no.
Yeah. I think that's also a very important tip. Feel free to say no to things that will not enrich
you. You can say no.
That will not, you know, that maybe don't interest you.
So we have the ceramic.
Jorge, yes, we will be most probably be adding noise textures to the objects and things like that, but that is something you do in Photoshop, right?
The texture?
Yes.
Yes. We are close to the end in Illustrator. So now I'd like to create a square in this square and the pattern. So this might be 1, 2, 3, 4. I can't see, it's too far from my eyes. Yes, 3, 4, and then okay, and I duplicate it.
So Midden Camper, yes, that's an interesting thing. Like I was baffled by that as well. Like, how, you know, if you don't use layers, how can you manage to put the squares behind the flowers? That's because the flowers were the last thing she was drawing, and basically every object you draw in Illustrator always goes on top of the next one. Okay, so basically, like, she drew the flowers and then she drew the square on top of it, and then simply by using the Alt square bracket, she sends it between the drawings
back.
That
I can show you, because even if I had don't create layers, you can see all the shape here.
Yes. Ah, inside,
you know?
Of the symbol.
And this is right here.
Yep.
So you can even name the group, and all the symbols are here. Maybe it could help to understand. Okay, it's come on, Illustrator.
Ah, yes, now it's thinking a little bit.
Yeah, say no, it's midnight in Paris. Okay. I forgot to draw this part.
The rails.
Okay. No, I can create. I'd like to create.
And also working with symbols, like changing all these things into symbols, the artwork is very complex, but each symbol is actually one entity, and so it's I think it's a very good way to manage complex illustrations.
Because if your client wants you to change the window, you just have to change one.
Yes. And clients always want to change the window.
Oh, the color. Yes.
No, there's always something that needs to be changed. And if you have organization in your work, it's so easy to go back and change something.
Yeah, because when you used to work with clients all day long, you know that, as you say, mm-hmm. you always want to mm-hmm. change something, but you begin to think yeah. like him.
Yes.
Maybe it's going to say that, okay, so I created a separate layer for this part mm-hmm. and a separate layer for this part.
Yeah, so technically, yes, there are still layers. There, it's like now, I mean, I don't know. How many layers do you have now?
Big layer, just two.
Two big layers?
No, because I'm
isolated. You're in a group?
Yeah. Just in 1 minute. Here.
Yes. So one is the there's the sketch. Okay.
Yeah. Oh. No, it's okay. The sketch.
And basically, you put everything in the colors layer.
Yes. Then you know, everything okay. is here.
These are the various groups. Yes.
Mhm. So, I'm just going to. Sometime I just add a new layers. Just to choose a color for the background. Yeah. Okay.
Well, the concept between symbols and Photoshop Smart Objects is a little bit different. Photoshop Smart Objects basically includes whatever you put in the Smart Objects, and that can be an Illustrator file, that can be an image, that can be text, that can be anything really. In a smart object, and when you double click on the smart object, it'll open in whatever application you created the object with. Illustrator symbols, on the other hand, are a compound of shapes you created in Illustrator that you can reuse very, very quickly. And like Maite says, it's very easy to change a window. Maybe do you want to make an example?
Yeah.
Just pick any window and let's just change the color and see the magic happen in the illustrations. Even if maybe we don't want.
Or maybe just add a shape.
Add
like
a
that?
Shape, okay. Which we can remove right afterwards.
Yeah.
Okay. And you see, that
you
shape
see?
Has been added to all of the symbol instances, we call them. The symbol instances. This is genius.
This is very easy. And maybe if you can add a shadow. And here we go. The shadow is under all the window here. So we just have 1 hour. So maybe I'm going
right,
to.
Right, Brad. Says every client wants to change the window, I know. But clients should be watching videos like that to understand the work that goes. Behind it.
But most of the time they are sweet.
Yes.
Yes.
No. Not all clients are bad. Absolutely.
No clients. Okay, so maybe we could go to Photoshop and then I will come back to Illustrator mm-hmm. if
okay.
I had time to add details or something.
Mm-hmm.
So let's do a poster. In Itra.
Here I'm super interested to see how you're gonna put that Illustrator file into Photoshop.
It's very easy.
Yes?
Yeah, it's pretty basic. Often I create my own brush, but I've decided for this session to show you how you can use the basic brushes to add texture.
Ah, no, no.
So everyone can do it. Okay, so I select all the tramway. It's not the tramway, so the word.
It's a tram.
Tramway, it's a tram.
Cable car.
And then I passed as a smart object.
Yes, that's what I wanted to see. As a smart object, and this is where we come back to this concept of Photoshop smart objects and symbols. They're you know, they more like conceptually, you know, they do kind of the same thing, but they're not the same thing. And the really cool thing is that if Maite now pastes this cable car into Photoshop as a smart object, by double clicking on the smart object, Illustrator will open.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah.
And my computer is going to sleep.
It's just thinking.
No, no, just no. It's okay.
It says,
I was afraid.
Maite, it's 11 p.m.
Yeah.
No, I don't want to work anymore.
Yeah.
Yes, let's do the giveaway. Yay. Okay, so this is how it works. So we have Nightbot, who's been pretty pesky today, banning people left and right in the chat for for using too many heart emojis.
So much.
Yes. Yeah. We should check in with Nightbot. But the way it's gonna work is, okay, so first of all, there's the subscribe button, and I'm just showing the subscribe button because if you are a subscriber to the Creative Cloud YouTube channel, which you can do right now here on Adobe Live just by clicking the subscribe button, you have more chances to win. Five times more chances to win. Okay, it doesn't mean that you can't win if you don't subscribe to the channel, but you have more chances. And then what I want you to do as well is let's use a keyword, and in this case let's use Photoshop. What do you think, Michael? Should we use Photoshop? Photoshop. Okay, so put Photoshop in the chat, okay, and Nightbot will be choosing one of you to be the lucky winner of the print that we'll be making with the Portugal, the Lisboa illustration from Maite Franchi. All right, so the keyword is Photoshop. Chat a sentence with Photoshop to get a chance to win a signed print. Okay, movie boy, here you go. All right, the chat is going wild. Photoshop. Now, if you make a phrase and say how cool Photoshop is, you know. Okay, Photoshop, Photoshop, Photoshop. It's a smart object, Photoshop.
Whoa.
Yeah, okay. I can't wait to see what Mike A. Franchi does with Photoshop. That's a good one. All right. Let's keep that running for another maybe 30 seconds, 1 minute. And then we're going to have the bot actually choose a winner. Okay, Photoshop, my love. Yep, all caps won't work. Nightbot hates all caps. And will ban for all caps. Do you get angry when people write you in all caps?
No, it's okay.
It's okay? To me, it feels like they're screaming at me.
Yes, a little bit. But it depends. I think about my grandmother who is learning how to use an iPad. Sometimes she uses caps like, hey,
yes.
I'm here.
No, that gets even funnier because like the first letter is small and then the rest is
yeah.
Okay. Because, because shift, okay.
Well, you know, she's trying.
Yeah. All right. Mikael, whenever you're ready, let's ask Nightbot to give us a winner. And I can tell everyone that by the end of these 3 days, Michael Shays will be able to say winner.
Okay, it's Joshua McDonald.
Joshua McDonald. All right, you have won the giveaway. So Joshua, what you need to do now is reach out to M. Shaz, Michael Shaz on Twitter. Michael will be putting his Twitter handle here in the chat in a second, just for you. Reach out on Twitter and we will be giving you all the information you need to actually get your hands on the autographed print from Maite. What are you doing, Maite? Is it working?
If I hope so, yes.
Okay.
Great. It's a little bit slow. I'd like to add a background.
Yes, congratulations to Joshua.
I hope you like the print.
Yes.
No.
Here we're still in Illustrator.
Yes, I came back in Illustrator to add a background to the ceramic. But I don't know why it's not working. Okay, so. Ah. I get it.
I'm so lost after the switching from Illustrator to Photoshop. Yeah, we're still in Illustrator because Maite wants to add a background to
as you can see here,
the tile.
Yeah, it's the vector smart object.
Mm-hmm, yes.
So it means that it's from Photoshop.
Yeah, this is the point. This is the point. Like if you use Illustrator art in Photoshop as a smart object, simply by double-clicking on the Photoshop layer, you will open Illustrator and you can make all the changes you want to that Illustrator file. Boom. No?
No?
Oh. Ah, okay.
Oh, thank you, Illustrator. Yeah.
It was about to choke, but...
I also...
All right, Min Camper, we're moving to Photoshop so that Maite can add her textures that she will be adding with brushes. And she will be using brushes that are available in Photoshop and that anybody can use.
Oh, I can't do anything. Ah, okay, great. So. I just want to hide a part on the tramway.
Mm-hmm.
It's so long.
Ah, so you just created a mask?
Yeah. And now with the brush, I try to... Oh.
Oh, this is why you didn't finish the tramway on the side.
Yeah.
Because you knew you were going to cut it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And here we go.
Okay. Oh, I love layer masks.
Maybe... No.
No.
Something like that. It will be cleaner.
And bam.
Okay, so save it. So now we have our tramway. And I'm going to add lights to the background. So I created a shape. And I had white. I changed the opacity. And then turn it just like that. Oh.
How big is the file? No, that's okay.
No, that's okay. I don't understand why. Okay.
Good night, Hossein. Thank you for staying so late.
There is an issue already. I don't know.
What would you normally do to fix the issue? Go out for a coffee.
Yeah, I don't know why it's so long. It's slow, very, very slow. Okay, maybe if I closed Illustrator. No. Okay.
Okay, something is happening.
Yes, I think so.
Close your background programs, Ivan says. Yeah, Ana Uribe. Yeah, it's coming out very nice. I agree.
Okay, just we'll do the square later.
Okay, is it just the square that's that? Oh well, the zooming and everything works fine.
Yeah, so it's okay.
Yeah.
Maybe, yeah, great. Maybe it's going to work. So, I like the color, but I'd like to add an atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm going to use brushes, basic. You can create your own or add a new one. So, I like...
So, these are the brushes you have right now. Are these the regular Photoshop brushes?
Yes.
But you said you also create your own.
Yeah, and I scan a lot of stuff.
Ah, there you go. And create your brushes with scanned images.
Okay. Yes. So, I open a new layer and I join to the... Oh no, so to the tramway. My mistake. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Then I come back to the tramway and use. What's the name of this tool?
This is the. The magic wand tool.
And the magic wand?
The magic wand tool. I usually call it the tragic wand tool. It does selections like that, yes.
Yeah, I know.
But sometimes it's really the fastest tool to select, yes.
Because I use it like that. And I do a
this
mask.
This is so great. People in the chat are explaining to other people who just came in exactly
you.
What you did. You know. She did
Thank
certain
you.
Illustrator, she used symbols, she did that, you know.
I hope it's going to work because of, I don't know. So I change the blending mode by multiply.
Okay. Ah, yes.
Wow, magic.
This is to give it the grit. Is that even a word? Let's see. Yes, small loose particles of stone or sand. The grunge, right?
And I add it.
Brad, no, come on. Like, Maite likes working on a PC. Why not? No. And
yes.
The truth is, the applications work just as, you know, just as well on both platforms. So, I'm a Mac person myself, but I wouldn't be able to. It was very funny. I was at a trade show maybe 2 weeks ago, and I was in a panel discussion, and we had a computer.
Mm-hmm.
Said, here's a computer. You can go online whenever and like look at stuff. And none of us in the panel, we're all Mac users, and we didn't know how to operate the Windows machine. So, so some light and shadow, huh?
Yeah. I may be going to add lights before adding a lot of texture.
There you go, Jorge. PC. Oh, he even has a Mac and a Windows. And the Mac has Windows 10 installed on it. Well, you know.
I just had it gradient, but by changing the blading mode, you can add contrast with that.
Yes. And this is something that's much easier in Photoshop, right? To to work on global things like that.
It's awful. Come on, PC. Okay. I don't know. It's the French word.
Chromie.
Chromie.
I would call it just colorizing colors. No, color.
You know, it's not like a big difference, but add like to the variations of the color. And then I'm going to create
So what resolution are you working here? This is an A4, right?
A3. Maybe okay. we could change.
No,
just maybe to get faster.
No. Oh, it's, how many megs is it right
no,
now?
No, but it's so long.
Okay. Yeah.
So
let's do an A4 if it's.
For print, we can say like maybe 200.
Yeah.
It's okay.
That's fine. So it was an A3 at 300 DPI.
Maybe it get well. It's better, I think. Yes. Let's go for a yes, but I'm not convinced. Oh, I can change the size or anything.
There's a shortcut for changing the size.
Yeah, but I can't with the Alt.
Ah.
You know?
Getting any faster? Yes,
a little bit.
You feel the illustration.
So we could add texture if it's work. Yeah, it's such a suspense.
Yes.
Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Boom. Okay.
Okay. So it's so big. Oh. So I convert to smart object.
Oh, for yes, okay. Because smart objects, you use smart object for your Illustrator documents or document content, let's say, and now smart objects for images as well.
Yes, because if I want to change the texture, the metal, I just have to go to click and change it. I can keep
smart
like. The blending mode, the mask, and I don't have to recreate a texture, but just change.
Oh, there we go.
So I use this like the yellow sections. Yes. and invert it.
Ah, so you're just putting it on the side of the tram with a gradient.
With a gradient.
In the layer mask.
Yes. And I'd like... Oh, please, Photoshop. Stay with me, Photoshop. Yeah.
Do you work on any other devices, or is that your primary machine?
No, it's the... I work with the big PC.
Okay.
Most of the time. If I had to work on big piece.
Yes. What's the biggest piece you ever worked on?
It was a wall.
Okay.
It was so big, I think like 5 meters.
Okay.
But in the 300 dpi. Yeah. So the file was like huge.
Okay.
I had to cut it in 5 pieces.
I bet.
But it was great. It was for a school, if I remember well.
Adding that metal texture really changed the side of the tram.
Sorry.
Right, Chris?
It's really, really slow.
Ivan asked, did you create or capture the texture yourself? Are you a texture hunter as well? Or?
Yes, of course. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of pictures. I take it in the street, the walls, and I scan. Mm. You can scan anything you want, like you say sand.
Yeah. So Brad here is asking a very good question. Does Maite save elements to CC libraries?
No.
Because that's another way of working with smart objects as well, is saving them in CC libraries, and then from the CC library, taking them into Photoshop. You know, like
just like
it's
that.
It's a library that you can put. You know, what are these things?
It's
these are
the
in a library. Oh, okay.
Yes.
Yes. You just created
those? It's the tram and the ceramics.
Yeah, absolutely. These are smart objects. And okay, because that's in the newer versions of CC, when you import a smart object, it says, do you want to save it into a Creative Cloud library as well?
Ah.
And the benefit of that is that, you know, if it's in your Creative Cloud library, you can access it whenever.
Okay.
And when you go back to your home machine, to your office machine, these elements will be there in the CC library.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. Imagine all your textures in a CC library.
Yes. I definitely have to do it.
Or a set of your favorite brushes in a CC library. And the cool thing is that you can share CC libraries as well.
Really?
Yes.
Great.
You can say, I want to share it with the world, or I just want to share them with Rufus.
So if I can share, I can also get...
Yes, absolutely.
Wow, that's great.
No, it's very, very powerful.
Like types... textures.
Yes, look,
picture.
Let's have a look. If you open it, see down here, you can if you hover over it, is graphics, okay? Next to it is character styles,
effects,
layer styles, and you know, whatever. It depends on the application you're using, but
that's great.
This is a great way to store elements that you frequently use.
That's smart. Mm.
And the thing is that they're available anywhere. So
that's so cool.
If you forgot your favorite texture on your Lyon computer,
yes.
What do you do now?
That's what you can share.
Yes. So if you want to share
great.
This, for example, if you go in the little arrow here, no, this one, this one here. Go click on it.
Link.
Yeah. You say. Collaborate or share link, or collaborate will mean that I whatever I put in the library you also see.
No, the best.
And whenever there's changes to the library, I get notified about it. So for example, a workflow that I frequently use to show that is you know, if we work in a studio and maybe there's a company logo and the company logo changes, if it's in a Creative Cloud library, everybody has the new logo.
That's great.
Yeah. So this, for example,
is
basically you can share it from there, and Creative Cloud will also create the previews for whatever you had in there. And yeah, it's a great, great new way of working.
Yes, so great. I don't remember.
So clarity instruction, yeah, they did automatically go there when Maite imported them as a smart object into pasted them as a smart object. Actually, maybe we can just do that again. Just maybe you take a very simple element in Illustrator. Is Illustrator still open or has it?
I can't do anything.
Never mind. We'll
I'm
get
sorry.
There, Maite.
I don't know why.
And I know a lot of people easily share it easily to Rufus. Yes, if I mean all of you are like really liking the content that we're creating here with Maite, we will be live again tomorrow and the day after for another 8 hours of incredible illustration skills. But the best way to be notified about live events here is if you go, let me see if I can get my finger right down there. There is a button in adobelive.com that allows you to subscribe to the Creative Cloud YouTube channel, and you get all the information. The best way, of course, to follow us is to come right here on the adobelive.com webpage, because the chat is here. There's a possibility to find out more about the speakers. There's a speaker. There's a full schedule, and as you can see on the schedule right now, we're going to be starting again tomorrow with Dan Mumford at 4 p.m. Central European time. And I think the schedule actually updates to your local time, which is so cool. I mean, you know, how many times have we lost people who were coming in an hour late? Oh, it has started already. Now with this new way of scheduling our streams, it makes it really, really easy for you not to miss them. And if you really don't want to miss anything, there's even a little button to add to your calendars, so you can have it there in your calendars. There's a link to the replays. There's a link to the speakers. By clicking on these links, you can find out more, and the chat. So the really the best experience you can have with this Adobe stream is by coming here to the adobelive.com webpage. And I've been just blabbing about. What have you been doing, Maite? Is everything working fine?
Yes.
Okay.
I think so. I'm adding texture in the tramway.
Yes, Clarity Instruction, you're still getting 20 gigs of storage with Creative Cloud, but library items don't count to that storage, which is pretty cool in my humble opinion.
Okay, let's get it.
Yeah, Brad, Creative Cloud libraries are, you know, a really important focus for us. And we are working very hard to get them right, to make them work like people expect them to work.
Should watch the Mexican.
Yes, and if anybody's interested in what's coming at Adobe or any
Creative Cloud.
fascinating and inspiring content, join us for the Adobe Max online, which will be here on adobelive.com. If you subscribe to the channel, you will be alerted. We will be streaming the keynotes. The keynotes are really cool because we're going to be talking about our products, the new workflows we're going to be enabling. We also have a whole bunch of great speakers at these keynotes to show what's the future. We have Tarantino. That's right. Yes, Tarantino, our keynote.
Mm-hmm. Great.
And so yeah, so check it out, adobemax.com or max.adobe.com. That's fine too. And and if of course if you can join us in person in San Diego, that would be awesome as well. And that's happening in exactly 2 weeks from now.
Great.
Yeah, Wednesday.
Yeah, yeah. Starts Wednesday. Yeah, we're Wednesday already here in Central European time.
Oh yeah.
Oh no, we're not. No, of course we're not. No, we're still Tuesday.
Getting there.
Adobe Max is our creativity conference, and we have Adobe Max once a year. Typically, it's in Los Angeles. This year, we are doing it in San Diego, and basically, it's 3-4 days of keynotes of Adobe presenting whatever is coming, the new technologies that we have, and it's also an incredible way to get training, because we have hundreds of classes across the 3 days of Adobe Max, or 4 days. Is it 4 days? Yes. Yeah, Friday from when from. Yeah, it's more of 3 days. No, but there's pre-conference classes and things like that, and there's gonna be just under 10,000 people this time. I think it's like crazy. So there's gonna be a lot of cool things happening at Adobe Max, and another interesting thing: if you can't join us at in San Diego, all of the content that we create at Adobe Max will be published online as well. And Michael and myself and the whole Creative Cloud team will be streaming live from Adobe Max here on the Adobe Live channel. Like how many hours a day, Michael? From to?
Eight hours a day.
So Adobe Max will be our next large stream.
More than 20 guests.
We have more than 20 guests on our schedule. So that will be very incredible. Just wish I could drag items up and down in the list of the Creative Cloud libraries. Yes, we're listening.
And it still doesn't work. Okay. So.
Okay. So, it's like it doesn't say Rufus down here. It says Maite Franchi. So, no, because I was just talking, blabbing.
And you were working,
and so maybe it's time to check in with you. And what's happening here?
So because I can't draw a square in Photoshop, so I decided just to create one in Illustrator CC and import it
and paste it. All right, you see? Oh, redo that. Add to my current library. Mm-hmm. Okay, and basically that smart object you just created also got copied over to the Creative Cloud library.
So all the tramway, the ceramics are already.
Yeah, already there.
Yeah, I can't turn it. I don't.
Issei is asking a question for you. Do you ever do passion projects on the site? And if so, what kind?
Sorry?
Passion projects. Like projects for yourself.
Yes, I built with my boyfriend a studio of screen printing in our garage.
Oh, that's cool.
That's pretty artisanal, but it's great. I like it.
Screen printing. Great.
It's what I like to do.
Printing with
a Denman for it does? It's very, very difficult, but I like it because you draw with your hands. That's cool. Definitely not a square.
Why don't you do the square simply in Photoshop?
Because it doesn't work, but I don't know why.
Even with the, the vector shapes?
no. Ah, yes, you're right.
It's just a square.
Yes. Okay, then I just want soft light.
Yeah.
Opacity here. And I duplicate the square to create, you know,
a
light.
Oh, I see. Yes, very nice.
So I group.
Brad is saying it's always good to have somebody talk and let the artist work. Yeah, it's always difficult to find the right balance, right? I mean, you know, there's so many questions that we want to ask you, but then you also need the time to actually do something.
You have 30 minutes to ask questions.
Yes, 30, no, less than that. We have about 20 minutes, 25
minutes.
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, Don, question, couldn't be a long question if you want.
Okay.
These tiles look so great. With this texture now?
Yeah.
Yeah, the tiles, yeah.
What is the tile?
The
ceramic?
Yeah.
Ah,
it's
okay.
It's called a tile.
I had a texture.
Mm-hmm.
And the blending mode is the overlay.
Ah, okay. What texture did you add?
It's the one here, like metal or something.
Oh, okay. Like brushed metal.
Yes.
Okay, awesome.
But you can try a lot of texture, you know.
Don is asking, do you have any experience using Adobe Illustrator Draw or Adobe Photoshop Sketch?
Not at all.
Do you have an iPad?
No.
Do you have a tablet of any sort?
No.
Okay.
No, because I for me it's difficult to draw.
Mm-hmm.
I stuck at it.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, I always think with shape, rounded rectangle
mm-hmm.
and square.
Yeah.
I don't use the pen tool. For me, it's like, you know, a puzzle.
Mm-hmm.
But with my hand, it's difficult. I should improve and practice. So now, as we get
maybe for the sketching phase, you know, instead of scanning them in, you already have them in your Creative Cloud libraries, and you just drag the sketch. You don't even just.
Ah. Yeah, it's magic.
It's magic.
So.
You know the magic word, right? Whenever something magic happens in Illustrator, Photoshop, or say. Adobe Kadabra.
No.
Yes.
That's kind of cute. Okay, so I'd like to add this part here
mm-hmm.
because we have time. So
yes.
Here it is.
So Brian, yes, Maite already answered that question. Yes, she does create her own brushes and she collects brushes. So I think collecting and creating brushes is really fundamental for any digital artist because this is, you know, this is what allows you to quickly create.
Mm-hmm. But this time I'd like to show you that you can do texture with the basic brush.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need to pay like a set of brushes or
mm-hmm.
something. Create your own or scan stuff like bread or no. I don't like it. No. Definitely no. Just gonna and I'd like to cut this part. Okay.
Roberto
okay.
Romero says, great work, Maite. Congrats. Keep inspiring us.
Thank you very much. Do we have a new illustration to show me? With the
yes.
hashtag?
Let's
before
see.
The hand?
Let's see if
I'm
we...
I'm very curious.
Yes.
Do one more
Yes, 5 minutes to the next giveaway.
Photoshop, Photoshop. Will be this one.
Oh, Issei has sent some more. Has been continuing on the illustration here. Let's move to my screen and and just look at some of this work. So basically, the last thing we saw from Issei, okay?
With the bear. Oh.
Yeah, it was this one here, right?
So this cute.
Working on it in Illustrator, and this is the final.
You have any? I like it. It's gray. Maybe you could add some light.
For more shape, you mean?
Yeah, but like with the shadow.
Ah, but maybe it's night. There's
yeah, but with the fire.
Ah,
there's
yes.
Like it's like a point of light and everything is dark around. I don't know. Maybe you
very
could
good
try.
Yeah. Okay. This Julia.
That's fake.
What is this? Like
that's CrossFit.
Like, yes, okay.
Smart
be one. Fit or die trying, yes. Oh, this is for a children's book. The words are just blah blah thing. Please feedback. Let me open them.
Oh, that's cute. Oh, I like this one.
Oh, yeah.
I like the bold, what do you say, contour?
The thick lines.
Thick lines, the bold thick lines, I like it.
Yeah, I like the consistency of the thick lines. In this case here, you know, there's some thinner lines, but basically it's the thick lines.
Yeah, that's great.
It's for a children's book, it's beautiful.
It's perfect for children.
And watching James Curran's session before, I could easily see this being animated as well.
Yeah, you like papers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like theatrical waves.
With the waves.
Yeah.
Hey, great.
Illustrator only.
I'm trying to maybe it's him on Dribble.
It's?
I like the movement.
Ah, yes. Of the meteors.
Yes. Great.
Oh, wow. Here we have something. An illustration. Okay, here. Maybe you can use some of Maite's tips about using, adding some texture. Like the Korg Monotron has this kind of, you know, rough texture to it. And I think.
Maybe you can scan, like, how do you say it? Tissue? Not tissue to...
Cloth.
Cloth. To add texture. Cotton. Yeah, fabric.
Okay, here we have something very literal from Franco Molina. Okay.
Thank you, Franco.
Thank you, Franco. James Curran. Okay, James Curran will surely be looking at that Hein Nguyen.
Oh, can you play it?
Yes, let's see. Curran. All right, yes.
Very fun.
Yeah, the possibilities are endless.
I like the hair.
And this is also something that, you know, that's more in the line of Maria Grönlund here, like with the... This is like a fascinating image as well.
Yeah. That's great.
Oh, we have another GIF or GIF.
I don't know. GIF.
I give up. cartoon technology. Oh, it's like a foldable little phone.
That's cool. That's great. Cool.
Oh, that's probably the inside of this flyer.
Yeah.
And then more. More animated That's for
I
James.
Like
yeah.
One.
People.
Whoa, it's endless.
Yeah, these endless GIFs.
A bit,
I mean.
A bit scary.
All right, let's go back to your.
That's great.
Lisboa.
Bravo.
The giveaway.
You want to get the giveaway, the keyword is mating.
They already know. How do they know?
Tell them in the chat.
You told them in the chat. My God.
You stole
our thunder here. Okay, so you guys know now, for those of you who have just joined us, we have a thing called Nightbot. And Nightbot will be choosing a lucky winner who will be winning a print from this illustration that Maite is working on and signed by her. Yeah, so the keyword is Maite. So yeah, you can write it that way. Let's see if somebody can write it the correct way, right? Because that's not how you write Maite.
I don't know this person.
And one thing that's very important, everyone, is down here there's the subscribe button. Okay, subscribers to the Creative Cloud YouTube channel have 5 more chances to win. Okay, so if you're a subscriber, you have more chances. Which doesn't mean that if you are not a subscriber, that you can't win. I mean, but hey, subscribe. Nightbot just kicked out somebody with all caps.
Yeah, no, he's very polite.
Did you change?
Oh
yes, please don't use all caps.
He said thank you.
Thank you. Did you change him?
I had to.
Yeah, he was a little bit.
I like the French sentence. That's so cute.
Beautiful work, Maite. Maite, awesome work, Maite.
Oh, thank you very,
Maite
very
not.
Much.
Thanks, Maite. Maite, president. All right, so as soon as Mikael presses the button,
ready?
Do you just press the button? Okay.
Boom.
Lucas Foley. And the winner is...
Lucas O.
Lucas O. Lucas O, please put yourself in contact with Michael M. Chez on Twitter. He will be writing it right here now in the chat. And he will be giving you all the necessary information to claim the prize. We will be printing these posters as soon as the stream ends in 2 days. We'll do it as quickly as humanly possible. Yes, Lucas O, you won. Because you tweeted Maite. You did Lucas actually say Maite, or did he say something more complex?
Just Maite.
Okay.
Sounds very creative.
Yes, Lucas O, even with, you know, just one word, you actually won a print. Maite, what's happening here?
I'm almost done. I don't like, you know, like these parts. So as we just have 5 minutes or 10.
Yes, yes. We are in no hurry because there's nobody after us. We can go on for another 2 hours if you want.
Okay, so let's have the entire city of Lisbon.
Mean camper, good night to you.
And what's this one? And okay, I think we got. Maybe I could add a frame. If someone have a question, maybe for tomorrow. Tomorrow, I think I show you maybe birdhouse.
a birdhouse.
Yeah. But a cute one, like maybe with a jacuzzi or something.
Oh, nice. Like a luxury birdhouse.
Yes. But a cute one. Not a weird one.
But this Lisboa illustration is really, really beautiful. I love it.
Thank you. It's almost done.
Can we rig Nightbot so I can win one too, Michael?
And it's okay. Maybe I could add something here. Use the mask here and enter it. Oh, please, Photoshop. No. My Photoshop is down.
Your Photoshop is down?
Yeah.
Okay. Just save it. Can you save it at least?
Yeah.
Well, also, that Photoshop has this really great crash recovery feature now.
No, but I think it's my computer.
Yes?
I don't know what. Yeah. Ah. Oh. Okay, save it. Up. Go, go, go. Great. Because I'd like to add maybe something behind.
Mm-hmm. We still have some time, so.
No.
So while Maite is finishing her illustration here, let me just go through our AdobeLive.com interface again, because there's everything you need to follow us tomorrow and after tomorrow as well. Down, just under me there somewhere. Yeah, there's the chat button, of course, which allows you to participate in the chat. There's a schedule for everything happening tomorrow. We already have Dan Mumford scheduled, and then we have Maria Grönlund again, we have James Curran, and again, Maite for the night shift.
With pleasure.
And then there's already replays available. So basically there's the live illustration with Dan Mumford that happened before, the live illustration with Maria, live animation with James Curran. It's already, everything's there already. For those of you who have missed the live streams, you can always go back and watch the replays. The cool thing about the live streams, of course, is the ability to join the chat and ask our guest artists all the questions you want, and get live feedback. And this is really the benefit of being here live with us. Then on the speaker tab, we also have all the information that you need about our speakers. So if you click on, you know, Dan Mumford or James Curran or Maite Franchi or Maria Grönlund, you get more information and links to their pages. And then there's, of course, our contest that's going to be going on for the next 2 days. We started today, so it's a 3-day contest. And basically, the rules are pretty simple. You need to create an illustration or an animation based on the theme Max, okay? Because Max is going to be our next big stream in a couple of weeks, live from San Diego in California. And then you need to share whatever illustration or animation you've created on Twitter or Instagram using the hashtag AdobeLive, okay? And you need to do that before October the 20th. 1 p.m. Pacific time. And we will be giving out to 10 winners, the top 10 illustrations or animations, or the top 10 creations, let's say like that. We will be giving out a 1-year Creative Cloud subscription to 10 lucky winners. So please do share your work, and the best of luck to all of you. And I see we're working with type now. Was that a font, or did you just design that?
No, it's a font.
It's a font. Nice. Yeah. I like that font.
It's Haymaker.
Okay.
It's a free font.
Mm-hmm. Do you use your Creative Cloud free fonts as well?
Yes.
From Typekit?
Yes. Yes, of course. But in my job, I'm not using types a lot. It's a shame.
Mm.
Because type is like amazing. The typographer, what do you say?
The typographer?
Yes. That's the best artist for me.
Yeah. It's that's wonderful. Probably one of the things that takes most time and most patience.
Very impressive.
Do you ever use type as an element? Like an element, like what do you mean, Brad? Like a design element? Or an element in your illustration?
Yes, maybe for neon signs in the city or something. Yeah, of course. And with a 3D. Yeah. So, for me it's okay.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Save it.
I've just saved.
And as we mentioned, tomorrow we will be working on a bird's nest.
A birdhouse.
A birdhouse. Yes. Birdhouse. Okay. With a nest inside.
No.
Ah, it's a birdhouse. Like a cage.
Yes.
Ah, so it's not a...
With wood.
Okay. Maybe so with a hole?
Yes,
hole. Okay. And with a jacuzzi, because it's a...
A small one,
yes. It's a small
but it's,
luxury
is
bird
that I wanted to show you how I create building.
Mm-hmm.
And I think maybe it's cute with a birdhouse.
Okay. Do you have the sketch already?
No.
No, okay. Never mind. So we'll just have to leave it to our imagination. And and again, let me just go through the schedule again. We're going to be starting with Dan Mumford at 4 p.m. Central European time. That is 8 or 7 a.m. 7 a.m. 7 a.m. Pacific time. Yes. Dan Mumford, 7 a.m. Pacific time. And then we have Maria Grönlund again. Dan Mumford is going to continue working on his illustration that he's started on the iPad using Adobe Illustrator Draw, and he's going to be working on that illustration during the next two sessions. So it's going to be a very complex illustrations. Maria, on the other hand, today we created a logo using the Fibonacci sequence, mm-hmm. which was pretty awesome. So if you missed that, watch the replay. Tomorrow I can't remember what we would. Yeah, she said she was gonna talk about the first ever tutorial she made, and let's we'll go through that. Okay. And then also James Curran will be working on a new GIF animation. I just say both, so everybody's happy. GIF animation, GIF animation. And then for the night shift, Maite will be back with us for day two from 10 p.m., which is exactly 1 p.m. Pacific time. Wow, we never have things at 1 p.m. Pacific time from this side of the world, usually. So great. And we're going to be doing the bird's house with you.
Yes.
Okay, nice. So make sure you all come back. What issue? Oh, okay. So make sure you come back tomorrow for more creativity. And until then, thank you, Maite.
Thank you very much.
Almost midnight
tomorrow.
Here. Yes.
Yes.
All right.